Good morning, children. Now let us start the first chapter of biology section, cell structure and function. First of all, let us talk about the cell theory. Cell theory. The cell is the smallest unit of life. So we all know it is the smallest unit of life, means anything which is made, which is living, is made up of cell. Cell is the basic structural and functional unit of life. Structure means it makes the structure also, and it is functional. Why? Because a single cell can also do all the life activities of the organisms. New cell arises from pre-existing cell, means we cannot make the cell. It arises where, from where it get birth or arise, it get from the cell, parent cell. The daughter cells are produced from the parent cell. And last is, all organisms are composed of one or more cells. So some organisms are unicellular and some organisms are multicellular, made up of more than one cell. Let's talk about the discovery of the cell. Now, in 1965, Robert Hooke was the first scientist to discover the existence of the cell with the help of very simple microscope. He has observed in the slice of cork. Cork is the bark of upper portion or bark of the tree, under simple microscope, and saw a compartment or honeycomb like structure, and the cork appeared like small compartments which is separated by walls. Let us talk about the discovery of the cell. So in 1965, Robert Hooke was the first scientist to discover the existence of the cell with the help of simple microscope. He observed that in the bark of a tree, bark is the upper portion of the tree, under his microscope, he saw a small compartment like appearance, like honeycomb structure or compartment like structure, which is being separated by a thin wall in between. So he has named it as a cell. Cell, Latin, in Latin it means compartment. On the basis of number of cells, the organism can be classified into two categories. First is unicellular organism. Living organism which consists of only one cell or single cell is known as unicellular. Uni means one, cellular means cell. So organism having one cell or single cell is known as unicellular. Examples are amoeba, euglena, etc. Now multicellular, multi means many, many cell organism or multicellular organism, which living organism consists of more than one cell. Examples are all advanced animals, plants, like earthworm, human being, etc. Now let us talk about the cell shape. Now shape can differ in different organisms, but also in the same organism having different organ, like liver, kidney, all organs have different cell shape. It depends upon the function what the organ is performing. Now coming to the shape, the cells can have the shape like oval shape, spherical, cuboidal, fiber like or polygonal shape. Now coming to the cell size. Now size of the cell differ in different organisms. The smallest known cell is PPLO, pleuropneumonia like organism. It is also known as mycoplasma. It is about 0.1 micron in diameter. Micron means 10 to the power minus 6 meter. And the largest known cell is the ostrich egg or ostrich cell, which is 170 millimeter in diameter. Cell membrane, it is also known as plasma membrane. It is the outer boundary of the cell that controls the entry and exit of the substance as per the requirement of the cell. Plasma membrane, it is present both in the plant cell as well as in the animal cell. In short, every organism cells is covered with a protective membrane that is known as plasma membrane. So in the time of corona also, the scientists are researching on this cell membrane that is made up of glycoprotein, glucose, protein and fat. Now the next wall is the cell wall. It is exclusively present in the plant cell, fungus cell, bacterial cell, and it is absent in the animal cell. Cell wall is it surrounds the plasma membrane. It provides rigidity, support and protection to the plant cell, and also it gives shape and size to the cell. Let us talk about the cell organelles which are present inside the cell which to perform different functions. Like first is cytoplasm. Cyto means cell, plasm is liquid. That is liquid that is present inside the cell membrane and which perform different function. Liquid is like gel and it contain all the different organelles inside the cell. Now inside the cell there are different cell organelles which perform a specific function in the cell. So first is the cytoplasm. Cyto means liquid, cyto means cell, and plasm means liquid. Cytoplasm means cell liquid. The portion of liquid or protoplasm that is present in between the nuclear membrane and cell membrane is known as cytoplasm. It is gel-like structure and it contains other cell organelles. The second is the nucleus. Nucleus, you can say, the brain of the cell. It directs all the cell activities. It also contains a genetic material like DNA or RNA, and it is separated from cytoplasm by the nuclear membrane. Nucleus is protected by a membrane known as nuclear membrane. It is two-layer membrane and it surrounds whole nucleus. It has a small opening known as nucleopore which allow the material to enter and exit from the nucleus. The second organelle is the chromosomes. Chromosomes are thread-like structure present inside the nucleus and it is the inheritance material or genetic material, you can say. It is made up of DNA, deoxyribose nucleic acid, and it is responsible for the inheritance of the characters from one generation to the other. Cell organelles. These are the small portion of the cell which is responsible for performing different function. The first cell organelle is the plastids. Plastids are only present in the plant cell. They are absent in the animal cells. So plastid, the parts are chloroplast, chromoplast, chloroplast. Chloroplast are the plastid which contain chlorophyll, the green color pigment in the plant which impart green color to the plant also and responsible for the process of photosynthesis. And the other is the chromoplast. Other than green color, if the plant is having different color other than green, that is red or blue, so this is due to the chromoplast. Examples are croton. These are different types of plastid which are present in the plant cell. The other organelle is the mitochondria. It has different structure. It can be rod shaped or spherical shape and it is responsible for cellular respiration. It produces energy in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate, to perform different activities in the cell. That's it produces energy. That's why it is known as powerhouse of the cell. Mitochondria is known as powerhouse of the cell. It control other activities are, it control level of water, it control other material in the cell, it help in recycle, decomposition of protein, fat and carbohydrate. Let us talk about the part of the cell. Next cell organelles is the endoplasmic reticulum. It is the network of membranes that provide the skeletal framework to the cell, and the main role is it moves material around in the cell, or you can say it acts as the transporter in the cell. The next organelle is the ribosomes. Each cell contains thousands of ribosomes. These are small granule like structure which is responsible for the synthesis of protein inside the cell, protein synthesizers, and they are mostly present in the cytoplasm or float throughout the cell. Another cell organelle is the Golgi complex. It is the sac like structure, bag like structure, stacked one above the other in the form of piles of the sac, and it stores the material produced by cell. That is why it is known as storehouse of the cell. Next organelle is the vacuole. These are the empty spaces in the cytoplasm, and to store the excess of water and waste product in amoeba, it also help in digestion of the food. Another is the cilia and flagella. These are the small hair-like extensions present on the cell membrane, help in locomotion and collection of the food. Many organisms like paramecium have number millions of cilia, while Euglena has only single flagellum. You can see the structure of paramecium and Euglena. Paramecium is slipper-shaped animal. It is also single cell animal. Euglena, you can see the hairy projections known as cilia in the paramecium, and single a big flagellum in the Euglena. On the basis of nucleus, cells are classified into two types: prokaryotic, eukaryotic. Prokaryotic cells, pro means primitive and karyon means nucleus. So nucleus, the organism having primitive type of nucleus are known as prokaryotic. Nucleus in prokaryotic organism, either very small nucleus or no nucleus is present. No nuclear bounded membrane, that is nuclear membrane, is also absent. Examples are bacteria and blue-green algae. These are the only two organisms on the earth that have the prokaryotic nucleus. They reproduce asexually by budding and fission. They are very small in size, 1 to 10 micrometer. And they are the first type of cell during the origin. Now, another is the eukaryotic. Eukaryotic means, eu means true, and karyon, as you know, nucleus. So the organism having true nucleus. True nucleus means the nucleus is bounded by a membrane, that is nuclear membrane. Again, bacteria and blue-green are prokaryote. Rest of all the organism on this earth is the eukaryotic. The cell is the bigger than the prokaryotic. It is in between 10 to 100 micrometer, and some are even larger. And it includes all the group like fungus, protist, plant and animal cells. This is the schematic diagram of the animal cell. Try to locate all the organelles we have studied: plasma membranes or cell membrane, endoplasmic reticulum, nucleus, ribosomes, lysosome, mitochondria and Golgi apparatus. This is the cross section of an animal cell. You can locate the different organelles in this. This is typical plant cell, and you can know or you can compare the plant and animal cell. That is, cell wall is present in the plant cell, plastids are present, and different organelles which are exclusively present in the plant cell. This is typical plant cell, and you can compare the plant and animal cell by looking at this diagram. Some organelles, that is cell wall, plastids, they are exclusively present in the plant cell. This is the cross section of the plant cell. Now let us see the differences between plant and animal cell. So first is cell wall. Cell wall is present in the plant cell and absent in the animal cell. Second is the cell membrane. Cell membrane is present in both the cells. Plastids. Plastids are present only in the plant cell. They are absent in the animal cell. Mitochondria present in both the cells. Nucleus is also present in both the cells. Vacuoles in the plant cell, they are large and more in number because plant absorb more water. That's why storage is more in the vacuole. And in animal cell, it is of very small size or either it is absent. Chloroplast present in the plant cell and absent in the animal cell. Ribosome present in both the cells. Shape in plant cell, it is fixed due to presence of cell wall. And in animal cell, it is irregular. Golgi apparatus present in both the cells. Size of the cell, plant cell are larger and small cell, animal cells are smaller. Let us talk about the level of organization of living beings. There are two type levels of organization. One is non-living organization. It is known as atomic level. And another is the living organization. It is known as cellular level. So as you all know, non-living organism, atom. Atom is the smallest part of the matter. Atom combine to form the molecule or the compound. And different compound make the organelle. Just now we have studied the cell organelle. Now coming to the living organization. Living organization means cell. Cell is the structure and functional unit of life. That means from here, cells start being reproduction and it is considered as living. So the cell, as you know, it is the smallest unit of life and many similar type of cell combine to form the tissue. Means cell is gathered to form the tissue and tissue, similar type of work when done by different tissue, they organize to form a organ. Examples are liver, kidney, stomach. These are all the organs of the body. And these organs, when combined to form a particular task or work together, this is known as organ system. Example is digestive system, circulatory system, reproductive system, etc. And then this system on the whole work together to form an individual or organism. Cell division and cell growth. Cell growth, when cell is formed, it is of very small size and gradually it grows by taking the nutrients afterwards, and after reaching a particular size, it start dividing into new cells. That is reproduction or cell division. Cell division is the process by which a parent cell divide into two or more daughter cell. There are different process: binary fission, mitosis, meiosis, budding, etc.